So it takes voices like ours to say, where is it at? Why hasn't it happened? Why hasn't it gone down the pipe? Why is it still stuck in the state of Georgia and it's not filtering down to the farmers?
Okay. And for that lawsuit, is it just called the farmer's lawsuit?
It's called...
But you don't have to if you don't want to.
Right, yeah. It's in my head, and I've said it probably a trillion. The Pickford, yeah.
Yes, it's the Pickford.
Yeah, Pickford.
Yeah, Pickford 2.
Okay.
And the second one came as a result of their feeling that the opportunity for some of the farmers to file, that, yeah, it did not happen. Okay, now some of that was on our end. Okay, for not paying attention to deadline. Also, because there was some unscrupulous characters out there that were saying that they were filing in our behalf, and they were not.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and so a lot of that occurred also. So this is why the second round of payments are supposed to occur.
Mm-hmm.
But like I said, that money hasn't come down. Okay.
One last question from Cynthia.
Yeah, I was just going to ask. So how supportive is he of the efforts in Florida?
We don't know, because you know
it's kind of soon, but
it's too soon to, you know, he's
the campaign that he ran on.
Right, yeah. You know, what they say when they campaigning and what they say when it really actually happens, you don't know till you go to the floor and you say, okay, where is this? What's the deal on that? So my judgment on a personal level is kind of, I gotta wait and see what you gonna do, you know, because you may sound a certain kind of way. There is no guarantee, you know. Now, what I can say about Barack in terms of stepping up to the plate, not on a verbal level, but also on to push a legislative level, he has been very cooperative around those. But as you probably already know, not only he but his wife are really pro local food access. Okay, they are very pro local food access, and the reasons for that have to do with nutrition, obesity, especially child obesity. That's one of her pet peeves, you know. So we have found some comfort in how they have embraced the issues around farmers. Okay, the other piece that we work on a lot, and then, like I said, I can keep going, is we try as much as possible to engage 1890 land grants. Are you familiar with the definition of an 1890 land grant?
No.
Can anybody give me a definition of an 1890?
Might be on your test, so make sure you take some notes.
Oh.
There are can you give me a definition of an HBCU? Okay, right there.
A historically black college.
Okay. In the category of historic black colleges, there's a category called 1890 land grants. Basically, to make it as simple as possible, and I'm going to let you guys do some additional research on it, these institutions were formed to assist the farmers within their community to provide them with technical support and education around agriculture. And that's as far as I'm going to go. Guys, don't you have some kind of...
Well, they're going to report to you on the 5th on that. So okay. On the 5th, I want y'all to expound...
On 1890 land grants.
Yes, Cynthia, on what the 1890 land
grants. You see the shirt that he's got on? Okay. Another one, I could give you some examples here in Georgia, is Fort Valley State University. Okay. That's another one. The his alumni, FAMU, is one. But somebody needs on the 5th to tell me how many are there total. Okay, and what states are they located in? Okay, one last question.
No, I was just asking, is the 1890, is that like the agricultural and technical universities?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, it's 18.
1890 land grants. You know, these are the guys that have done it. There are a couple of people that he talked about earlier today And part of your scholarship that you got, you know, and stuff, was born out of 1899, or the concept of 1899. Okay? So I'll look for that on the 5th. That's a new piece. I'll put you to work.
Well, do you research? Do you research?